Lord, there's got to be at least three people in here who realize that they have not put on the full armor of God. They got a couple pieces on there, but they're missing the other four, the other three. Something's there. There's got to be some people here, Lord, that don't want to be Christians anymore. They want to be disciples. There's got to be some people here that want to make that sacrifice, that want to count the cost. They want to do it. They don't want to live like this anymore. They can't stand living like this anymore. I hate to say this, Lord, but there's people here that are recyclers. They come for deliverance here at the Arizona Deliverance Center, and I'm grateful for that. And then they go through deliverance. They have a one-on-one. They have all kinds of breakthroughs. They come down to the altar with Rick and here on Fridays, and they get a big deliverance. And then during the week, instead of renewing their mind, instead of dealing with the iniquity in their soul, they get reinfected with spirits because they took an offense, they lost their temper, they got mad at somebody, they were offended at somebody talking to them, and they just felt they should never be talked to like that. Something happened, and then the demons start getting back in. I call them recyclers. I don't know what you call them, Lord. Whatever you call them is what it is, but there's some recyclers here tonight, two or three, and you're going to say to yourself, hey, I got to stop this process. This has got to stop. I'm not supposed to be a recycler. I'm supposed to be constantly climbing and moving forward. If you're in the same spot now you were 2 years ago, something's wrong with you. I'm not trying to criticize you. I'm saying, hey, something wrong. You're in the same spot spiritually you were 2 years ago? Somebody needs to take stock of this. Somebody needs to count the cost on this thing. This thing needs to stop because you've been called a warrior to save your family. Some of your family members are flat out possessed. If they're not possessed, they're close to it. And they don't have anybody to help them. You're the only person on the map that knows anything about spiritual warfare. You come here. At least you had training about it. It's time for you to count the cost and make some sacrifices and fix this thing. You cannot keep going through deliverance and become a recycler. If you're still having the same stupid thoughts in your head now that you had 2 years ago, you have got bad spiritual problems. If you're still trying to overcome negative thoughts about yourself and questioning whether or not you're worthy or you're loved by God, you got some serious, serious spiritual problems. That should have been fixed the first week you were here. That should have been fixed years ago. You can't keep doing this. Time is running out. Time is running out. The rapture is only a few years away now. The tribulation is right on. It's heading right here. You can't be a Christian and make it through the tribulation. Some people believe the rapture is at the end of the tribulation. You know what that means? If the tribulation is only a few years away, all these Christians on the wide road have to go through it. Are you kidding me? None of them are going to make it. If you can't make it now, when there's virtually no persecution and no trouble now, you'll never make it through the tribulation. You'll collapse. You'll fold like a card table. There's no way to make it. You're not going to make it. Well, I got trouble now. My mother did it. My dad. What? You got family problems and you think you're going to make it through the tribulation? You got to be kidding me. You know what you're going to be doing in the tribulation? Using your little mark here on your right hand to get your food at Fry's. There's a little mark there with somebody's name there. What's his name? I don't know. But it's right here. And then you got to scan it at Fry's. That's right. That's what you're going to be doing. You're going to be a Christian with a mark on you, scanning it. Do you have any idea the kind of guts and faith it's going to take to not take that mark? Are you kidding me? Christians nowadays, they'll never make it. I'm telling you, they won't make it. You got in a fight with your wife, and now you're in a depression over it? And you're not going to take the mark? Are you kidding? You can't even overcome your wife? Are you serious? They'll stamp you, no problem, I'll take it. Come on now. Your family needs to be saved and healed and delivered, and you're the only person in the family that can do it. There's nobody else. You realize that? You understand that? You're the only person. God's calling you. You're being called. Now, I really do believe the tribulation's close. I think it's a few years away now. I think this thing's going to go down. It sure looks that way. But unfortunately, so are the Christians. Oh, Brother Mike, I'm not going to take the mark of the beast. I'm going to have my right arm amputated. Oh, you are? Well, guess where the other mark goes? On your forehead, it says. You're going to amputate your head? Oh, really? Some of you need your head amputated. Listen, this thing's about to go down, and you have got to get rid of this iniquity in here. Come on. You got to get rid of this thing. If you're still going through the same stupid thoughts you were 2 years ago, you got serious spiritual problems. The devil's got something on you. And that bondage needs to be broken now. You're being called now, not 6 months from now. This is your chance. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, I did the best I could tonight. Oh, I did all I could tonight. That's never good enough. But you, sweet Holy Spirit, I've seen you. I've seen what you do. I know what you do. It's awesome. Awesome. Everything about you is awesome. Everything about you is incredible. Thank you, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for your love, your grace. Where would I be without it? I'd be lost. I'd be gone. I didn't have it. But tonight is a day of reckoning. And I'll close with this. Brother Peter knew all about it when he told us the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of those who obey not the gospel of God? For if the righteous scarcely be saved, where will the ungodly and sinners appear? Any person that has some iniquity in here, and you've been putting it off, you don't want to face it, you don't like it. I understand that. I don't want to face it, and I don't like it either. I want you to come down here. We got to get rid of it. Because iniquity in the soul will block your anointing and your call and your giftings for the rest of your life. If the devil's got something on you, we have to break it off tonight. We have to do it. You can't continue living like this. This has to go. I want you to come down now for prayer. If you've got a stronghold of some kind, something's there and you know it shouldn't be there. Something's in your mind. Something's in your emotions. Something's bugging you. You know what it's kind of like? It's kind of like having a pebble in your shoe. You know, it's not killing you and you don't need to go to the hospital. But man, that pebble really gets annoying after a while. That pebble gets real old real quick. Let everyone that names the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, please forgive me. I've put this thing off for so long. It's a lust thing. It's an anger thing. It's a negative thought pattern about me, about my life, about my Christianity, about the love of God. Something is in my mind causing me to have a negative thought pattern. And I should have gotten rid of this 2 years ago. This should not be tormenting me anymore. I'm asking you right now to forgive me. Just go ahead and confess it. Oh, Lord Jesus, I am so sorry. I've got this stronghold in my emotions, in my mind. Oh, God, have mercy on me. I'm praying right now, Lord, that you will forgive me. Come up, devil. I am so sorry. I got to stop this right now. I'm going to stop it in Jesus' mighty name. By the power of the Spirit of the Lord, I'm going to stop this bondage and break it. I'm going to crack it like an egg. Satan, I'm going to drive you out of my body and my mind right this second. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of me right now. I command you, bondage, break off of me. I bind this horrible curse from my parents, the poverty curse, the physical illness curse, the disease curse, the mental illness curse. I break this curse off my family tree, my mother and my dad. Come on now. I command you right now in the name of Jesus, sweet Holy Spirit, start moving now. The Holy Ghost will start moving. Here he goes. I repent of this bondage and this stronghold. I will not put up with it anymore. This is the end of the road for me. This is the end of the road for me. I am not going to live with mental illness anymore. I am not going to live with cowardice anymore. I'm not going to take offenses anymore. I'm not going to get angry at people who criticize me and who point their fingers at me and they blame me for this, then they blame me for that. I am not going to receive that anymore. I'm not going to respond like that anymore. I command you, Spirit. I command you, you blaming Spirit. You shaming Spirit. I command you in the name of Jesus. I will never click on pornography again. I will never do it. I am not going to pick up a lust demon again from pornography. That is going to stop right this second. I am never going to recycle demons again from people criticizing me and pointing their fingers at me. I'm not going to receive that anymore. I don't care what they say about me. I don't care what they accuse me of. I don't care what the devil accuses me of. I'm not receiving it anymore. I'm not going to receive it. This is the end for me. This is the end for me. I've had enough of it. I've had enough of it right now in the name of Jesus. It's not going to happen anymore. I command you, Spirit, take your hands off me right now. Take your hands out of my soul. Take your hands off me right now. You just put your hands on your chest and your tummy. Put your hand there. In Jesus' mighty name, I will not take another offense. I will not take another offense. The Holy Ghost is starting to move. Here he goes. The Holy Ghost has all the miracles. Brother Mike don't have no miracles. We are looking to Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Satan, I command you right this second. I command you iniquity, this hidden iniquity. I command you to come up and come out right now. This bitterness, this anger and bitterness. Come on, ladies. Come on, ladies. You got anger and bitterness against a man. Some man put it to you. Some man hurt you. Some man betrayed you. Somebody hurt you. Today, you are going to forgive them no matter what. No matter what. In Jesus' name, I forgive you. Say it. Just say it. I forgive. Who is it? Mention their name. I forgive so-and-so. Bob, Harry, Jose. I forgive them. Speak it out. I forgive them in the name of Jesus Christ. I turn my back on taking offenses. I turn my back on getting angry at my mother, my dad, my husband, my wife, my kids, my stepkids, my adopted kids. They all offend me. They all criticize me. They all run me down. What's from this day forward, that will have no effect on me of any kind. None. No effect whatsoever. None. Nothing. Nothing. No more pain. No more pain. I will never use food as a comfort again. I will never use food as a comfort again. I will use the Holy Ghost from this day forward. From this day forward, I will not receive negative thoughts, fearful thoughts, critical thoughts in my mind. There you go. Take another big yawn. Come on out, devil. Big yawn. Good. There you go. Big yawn. Come on out. I will not take in another negative thought ever. I'm not doing it anymore. No more. No more. I'm not doing it ever again. No more. No more. No more. No more. I'm not doing it anymore. No more food. No more porn. No more alcohol. No more booze. No more. What's wrong with you?
You told me they were rock music demons before, and they're just attacking my chin.
Now, why are they doing it?
My back and my neck. I'm not a sinner anymore. I don't sin. I don't use drugs. I don't go to concerts. I don't listen to rock music.
Now, that has nothing to do with it. Now, what's going on in here? Yes, you
my
do.
My thinker doesn't work very well. I can't think very well.
You can't. Okay, you can think. Yes, you can. Ready? Repeat after me. I'll show you. Lord Jesus, my negative thoughts in my mind are opening the door to spirits to attack me. I'm having fearful thoughts, negative thoughts, lies, critical thoughts. I'm having faiths that cause unbelief. I have unbelief thoughts. And I'm going to repent of it right now. Dear God, please forgive me. Dear God, please forgive me, Lord. Come on, pray harder. Yes, please forgive me. Please forgive me, Lord. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me for my rotten thoughts, my doubts, my unbelief. Please forgive me for not learning spiritual warfare. Please forgive me for not fighting back that fear demon in there. I bind his power, and I command you to come out right now. Come out of me right now. Come out of me, I said. Come out of me, I said. Come on, get mad. Come out of me right now. Come out of me. Stop attacking me. Come out of me and stop attacking me. Come on. Fight, sweetheart. Do something. I command you. Come out of me. Come out of me. Say it. Come out of me. Atta girl. Good girl. Fight back hard. Fight back hard. Don't stand there and do nothing. Fight back hard. Satan, come out. Satan, come out. Satan, come out of there right now. I command you to come out right now. And she's got mind control demons. And to put your hand right here. Don't touch her. Put her in. Spirit of mind control, I command you to come out of this woman right this second. Come out now. Now in Jesus' mighty name. Come out now. Come out now, I said. Satan, I bind your power. Satan, I bind your power. Get out of me. Get out of me. Come out right now. Come out right now. I'm not going to recycle spirits anymore. I'm not doing that anymore. I'm not going to cast demons out and then let them back in tomorrow. No. I'm not doing it anymore. Come out of there right now. Spirit, you come out in the name of Jesus. Come out right now. Say that. Come out in Jesus' name. Atta girl. You got to learn spiritual warfare. You got to fight. You got to learn to fight. Like this guy does. He fights.
I fight.
Yeah, proud of you. Lord God, this iniquity keeps causing him to crash. Come on, there you go. Oh, there he goes. Come on there right now. Come on, buddy, right now. Come out, you ugly spirit. Come out, you pervert. You stinking pervert. Come out of that body right now. Go in Jesus' holy name. Go in Jesus' mighty name. I command you to go. Come out of there, you pervert. This guy's got sexual perversion demons. Come out of there in the name of Jesus, you unclean spirit of perversion. Come out in the name of the Lord. Get out of that body right now. Satan, I bind your power and I command you. Loose! I command you loose, I said. Loose, I said. Loose, I said. You stop tormenting me right now. I'm taking authority over you. I told you to come out right now. Come on, sweetie. Force him out. I force you to come out of me right now. I'm not going to fight like a coward anymore. Get out of that body and go. Get out of that body and go. Recycling demons. Are you the same now you were 2 years ago? You got major league problems. Major problems. You should have learned spiritual warfare 2 years ago. You should be ready for a full-fledged fight. Hey, what's bothering you? What is it?
I started, 2 years ago.
Oh, you did? Yeah. Doing what? Getting what out? What is it in there? You want to get rid of something. What is it?
Right now, at this very moment, isolation. I'm just being real okay with being alone.
Oh,
my,
you like that or you don't like it?
I don't know, brother. Mike. I like what? It sometimes, but right now I don't.
Do you speak in tongues? Did you ever before?
Very little, not really.
Okay, let's try it. Face this way so nobody can see you. Ready? Brobo shata. You pray after me. Robo shata. Melo masia. Oravaka. Belo masina. Elo valash. There. There it is right there. The Holy Ghost all over this kid. He just touched you. Oramashandro moshanda. You're not isolated tonight. You're in the hands of the Spirit of the Lord. Andu moshandra moshi. Holy Ghost, hit him hard. Touch him, Lord. Touch him, Lord. There he is right there. Devil, come on out of him while you're doing it. Come on out of there. There he is. Keep coughing. They're coming up right now. Keep coughing. Keep going. There they are. They're coming out now. Keep coughing. Thank you, Jesus. Get out of that body quick. There he is. There, keep coughing. Come out. They're coming out now. That's them. There they go. Thank you, Jesus. They're coming out right there. They come. Thank you, Lord. Hold that. Come out right now. Go. Satan, loose your hold of him. Go. There they are. They're coming out now. Quickly. Satan, come out of him quickly. Isolation. I bind your power. Break. Break right now in Jesus' name. Umashandra Moshandiva Velo Vasama. Urasha Visha Vadu Mosha Vega. Good. Say it. Durashatapa. Say it. Ura mashanda. Ura veveshenda. And sometimes you want to help the person get their gift of tongues going. So you repeat it and then they repeat after you. Okay? Just watch me here. Kore mashaba. Vakutami. Damoshavaka. Elosadia. Mokama. Andoria. See how easy you're repeating that? Now you add some syllables on your own. Ready? Any syllable. There's no wrong answer. Any syllable. Good. Just like that. Perfect. Keep going. There you go. Good. Louder. Good. Good. Keep going. Tindo moshandra mama mashandra vashite. Ura mashandra vashite. Help him, Lord. Help him, Lord. Akuma shandra. Receive the Holy Ghost. Ando moshandra moshanda. Give him the gifts of the Spirit, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Don't touch him. Don't touch him. Don't touch him. Ando moshandra moshindiri vivia. Some of these people are loaded with demons. You might pick up a transfer. This, you like that. Touch it again. Onda mashandromo. Come on, speak it out. Urasha vashatia. Good. Good. Thank you, Jesus. Tell him you love him. Come on, tell him you love him. You're not isolated anymore. You're a man of God with the Spirit of the Lord. Tell him you love him. Tell him you love him quickly. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I love you. Tell him you love him. Thank you, Jesus. I love you. I love you. I apologize for having iniquity in my soul after 2 years. I should never have this problem after 2 years. I'm sorry I hurt you, Lord. And tonight is the end of it. Tonight's the end of it. It's over. It's over. It's over. Tonight it's over. This is my night. Speak it out. Good, just like that. Speak it louder. Speak louder. Good. There you go. Good. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Urasha Varavashiva. Kambura Moshandaravoshide. Just speak in tongues with me. Ready? Everybody go. Kura Moshandri Voshadasa. Yinduru Moshandaravosireve. Speak it out. Kundereshevea. Yinduru Moshandraza. Kunduru Moshileva. Come on, speak it out now. The Holy Ghost is here. Anything can happen. Anything can happen when he's around. Anything can happen. Reach out with your faith. Take your miracle. Take your call from God. Push it. Push it. Just reach out and take it. You don't have to be mentally ill anymore. You don't have to have bipolar, schizophrenia, borderline personality. You don't have to have that anymore. You don't have to put up with this crap anymore. Step out with your faith. Step out with your anointing. Push it. You've wasted enough time. You've wasted enough years. Come on now. Come on now. Come on. Come on. Hey, will you help that old lady right there? She's stuck.
Which one?
This one.
In the front?
Yeah, right here. Duda. Come on now. The anointing is yours. Reach out and grab it. At the count of three, just take it. You don't have to be crazy anymore. You don't have to be insane anymore. You don't have to be on Social Security anymore for disability. What? No! 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 You don't have to be a spiritual loser anymore. Recycle demons all the time. Are you kidding me? That stops tonight. That stops now. Now. It stops now. You're going to forgive that person that stole everything from you. They took your kids. They took your family. They took your marriage. They took your money. Remember that person? They took you, stole your money. Remember that person that got you involved in some fake deal and you ended up taking a bath? Remember that one? Well, today, that curse is going to be broken off your life. You are going to forgive that person for robbing you. Come on, ladies. Did you get date raped? Did you get date raped when you were in college, when you were in high school? Did you? Did you get drunk? Did you, somebody put something in here? Did you get date raped? You're going to forgive that man right now. Lord Jesus, I forgive my rapist. I forgive my rapist in the name of the Lord. I forgive that guy that stole $10,000 from me. He took my money. He lied to me. Speak it out. He took my money. He took everything from me. That woman, I hated her for years. She took my kids. I got stuck with alimony and child support. Well, you're going to forgive that woman right now. You're going to do it right now. Because if you don't, that curse will follow you to your grave. The demons will follow you to your grave. You got to forgive your parents. Are your parents idiots, morons, and kooks? They are? Okay, join the club. Were your parents on drugs? Were they on alcohol and they drunks? Well, join the club. Join the club, my man. Sweetheart, join the club. So will the rest of us. The only way to break that curse off you is to forgive. And you got to do it now. You must forgive the person that has damaged you the most. You know who that is? Yourself. You must forgive yourself. That's the person you really hate. It's not your mom or your dad. It's not your husband or your wife. It's you. That's the person you hate the most. You must forgive yourself now. If you don't, the curse will follow you to your grave. The demons will follow you to your grave. Nobody wants demons following them to their grave. Come on. Stop it. Stop it. Just repent of it. Just repent of it. Nobody treats me right. Nobody likes me. Nobody cares. Stop it. Stop. The Holy Ghost likes you. The Holy Ghost cares about you. He loves you. Stop it. Stop the satanic complaining. Stop griping. Repent of it right now. Just forgive yourself. That's the person you really hate. You thought it was somebody else. It's not. It's you. You hate yourself. Just repent of it quickly. Your life is filled with regrets. You always think about your past. The demons put your past in your mind. The demons tell you to think about your childhood, your first rotten marriage, your second rotten marriage. They always put those thoughts in your mind. If I would have only had this. If I would have only done that. If I would have done that. Listen, do you want that curse broken off your life? Do you want that situation fixed? Then you got to repent of it. You got to forgive yourself for failing. You got to forgive yourself. You got to do it. There is no other way. You cannot survive by not forgiving yourself. What's wrong with that woman?
The tough lady.
What's wrong with her?
She's got pain in her finger. We're learning that okay, your mom. You just told me your mom was the first that hurt you.
Yeah, right? my how say I was adopted.
Well, mom, you got any bad feelings about your mom?
And my mom threw me away.
Adopted.
Do you have any?
I don't know, my adopted mom abused me.
Do you have any negative emotions about them?
No anymore.
Do you have any negative thoughts about them?
No, they already died.
I know they're dead, but do you have any negative thoughts about them?
No, I know they are kind of demon. I know.
Okay. Do you have any bad thoughts about yourself?
I always regret.
Do you have regrets about yourself?
Yeah, I should have done better. The religion should be better.
Okay, go ahead and repent of it, because that causes joint illnesses.
Yeah. How I repent? Lord, I forgive myself.
Yeah, you're killing yourself.
Yeah.
No, yeah, and why are you looking at him? Now close your eyes. Okay, man, you're talking to the Lord, not him and I.
Okay.
You're killing yourself. You got bad feelings about yourself. Look, it's starting to manifest in your joints. Come on and repent of it. Lord Jesus, I'm so sorry. I got bad thoughts and emotions about myself. Come on now. If you got bad feelings about yourself, that gal over there, she's got a lot of regrets in life. And her joints are starting to get jacked up. So when a person has a lot of negativity about themselves, the demons drive it into the body. And they start having weird pains, joint problems, fibromyalgia. Later on in life, arthritis. It all starts to crash. So you got to get them to repent of it. Hey, how'd that go?
Yeah, much better.
You're not isolated. See, you got the Holy Ghost. You can't be isolated. He's always there. Doesn't matter whether they are with you. You're with him. You're on the inside. They're on the outside.
I guess Brother Mike is because, like, since I let go of all that stuff that I used to do, I'm just not used to, I don't know, feeling like new like this, you know?
Yeah, but one of your problems is you're kind of an introvert, and you're really not. You're actually a strong person, but you need to be strong, a strong praiser. You were holding back there. While I was helping you, you kind of held back. Notice that? Yeah. Why don't you try it? Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your holy name. Try it. Raise your hands and tell him you love him and really mean it. Thank you, Jesus. Good. Louder. Keep going. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Give me a praise, Lord. Give you the glory. These people don't have any spiritual power because they're so introverted. They don't do anything. So what I have to do is coach them out of their comfort zone, which I'm doing with this guy. He doesn't feel comfortable praising in public. So I'm forcing him. See that?
Yes, I see that.
Yeah, and then once you get them to kind of do that, the Holy Ghost then moves on them. But if they don't do anything, the Spirit doesn't do anything. He just stands there and looks at them. Thank you, Jesus. I love you. What are you thankful for? Tell him. Anything? Yeah, of course, a lot. Go ahead and tell him. He likes to be reminded of all the good things he did for you. Tell him quickly. Tell him you love him. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Good, there you go. Good. Every day you do that. See? Praise draws in the anointing. Praise draws in the Holy Ghost. See that? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You got trouble praising God? If you do, your life probably stinks. Come up here so I can train you. Come up here. If you can't praise God, come up here right now. I'll show you how to do it. Come on up. Come on up. Well, I'm an introvert. No, you're not. Those are fear demons. Nobody's an introvert. That's a crock. Okay? If you got the Holy Ghost, you cannot be an introvert. You got to step out of your comfort zone and push it. Push it. That's how you get the anointing. That's how you fulfill your destiny. You got to push it. Thank you, Jesus. I give you the praise. Thank you, dear Lord. You've got all kinds of things to thank him for, don't you? Yeah, remember those times he bailed you out? Remember that time you should have been killed in the accident? Remember that time somebody came through for you at the last minute? Remember that time? Yes, you do. Well, thank him for it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for saving me from that car accident. Thank you for saving me from marrying that person. It would have been a nightmare. Thank God I never married him. Thank you for saving me. Don't you get it? Come on now. You got to let your praise go. You can't be an introvert and be a minister of the Holy Ghost. You can't do that. Introverts don't work. Okay? Catherine Kuhlman used to be an introvert. She was an introvert. She got filled with the Holy Ghost. She became an extrovert. Come on. You are not going to die an introvert. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, I give you the praise. Dear Jesus, I give you the glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, dear Lord. What's she talking about now? What's she talking about?
Her husband. She still has negative. She's fearing of getting transfer spirits from him, and she's got to repent of negative thinking about him.
You want your hands to fall off? You want them to fall off?
I want to fall off.
No, you got to be serious about this.
Yes.
Yeah. You got to repent of that.
I repent.
No, really repent. Stand over here and listen to this gal right here. She's got brain demons. So she gets distracted real easy and she doesn't listen. Watch her. Jojo. Her? Oh, yeah. Huge.
She's gone through 4 steps of the miracle list in like an hour.
Yeah. That ain't gonna do it. That'll work. What's going on with you, lady? What's your story? Huh?
Can I ask you something?
Well, yeah, you sure can.
I was diagnosed with an autoimmune disease 9 years ago. The doctor said that there is no healing, but I know God can.
What's the name of it?
Lichen plano pilaris.
What?
Lichen plano pilaris.
What's the symptoms?
Burning of the scalp.
Oh.
hair shedding. And the hair doesn't grow back anymore.
Okay, great. Now, stand this way. Autoimmune diseases are a soul problem. It's caused by negative emotions in the soul. And over the years, those negative emotions, the demons use them and they turn on the person's body. And the body starts attacking itself. Because the person attacked themselves for years. Did you used to hate yourself years ago? When you were little? Okay, that's it. Raise your hands, close your eyes. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you see this beautiful woman standing here? The devil told her she was fat, dumb, and ugly when she was young. And that was a lie. And she believed a lie. And then the demons gave her an autoimmune disease. And tonight she's going to repent of it right this second. Lord Jesus, I repent of listening to demons tell me I was fat and ugly. And I was valueless and worthless. I'll repent of it. I'll repent of it in Jesus' name. This gal has an autoimmune disease. That's a soul problem. So everybody that had an autoimmune disease years ago, they used to hate themselves. And then over the years, the body turns on the self and starts to eat itself up. So they got to repent of all that. Come on, you're not done yet. You're stalling. Now, come on. All the bad thoughts you had about yourself, about your body, you had body dysmorphia when you were growing up because you were told that you were ugly and fat. That's what they told you. Yeah, now, go ahead and repent of it. Your Heavenly Father doesn't see you ugly or fat. He never has. He never has seen you that way. He's been crying over your life. Crying because you're hurt so much. You don't need a healing from autoimmune disease. You need to repent of hating yourself. Fear spirits get in the body, and then the body starts turning on themselves. There's no cure for it. They can't be healed. He can, but medicine can't fix it. It's not curable. Come on, just repent of it now. You had bad thoughts about yourself for years. Come on, let your tears go. You're holding back tonight. Why are you holding back? You're supposed to be healed tonight. Dear Lord Jesus, I'm so sorry. Tell him you're sorry. Tell him you love him. Tell him you're sorry for what you've done. Tell him you're sorry for what you've done. Come on now. Lord, I'm so sorry. I hated myself. I looked in the mirror and I said, oh, I'm so ugly. I repent of it. I listened to people tell me, my parents, my brother, he always looked at me and made fun of me and said I was fat. What's your brother's name?
Colleague.
All right, tonight we're forgiving him in the name of Jesus. He's still alive. Is your brother still alive? Okay, go ahead. You got to pray for him. Come on.
I don't want to speak in the microphone.
No, okay, don't speak in the microphone. Now stand right here and forgive your brother. If you don't forgive your brother, you're going to die of autoimmune disease. You won't die? if you don't want to die, you better forgive your brother, sweetheart. Let's go. There is no way you can leave here with bad feelings for your brother. You got to pray through right now. Come on now. You got to listen to me. You got a psycho brother, a psycho sister. Hey, join the club. Almost everybody's got one of those. You got to forgive them. I mean, from the heart. That's what Jesus said. That's an exact quote. If you don't forgive these people from your heart, you get to die with an autoimmune disease. You get to die with cancer. You get to die mentally ill. You get to die with a lifetime of stupidity and pain. Now just repent of it. Thus saith the Lord, I repent of listening to my brother criticize me and make fun of me and run me down and degrade me, and I forgive him tonight. I forgive my brother right now. Come on, sweetie. Pray harder. Come on, sweetheart. Pray harder. Pray harder. I forgive my brother and my sister. I forgive my mom and my dad. I forgive my adopted mom, my adopted dad. I forgive all of them. I don't want to die of an autoimmune disease. That is not my call in life. Tonight, this autoimmune disease dies. I repent of hating myself, having regrets about my life, regrets about my body. I repent of it right now. Come on, sweetie, let your tears go. No, you don't worry about that. You let your tears go quickly. Come on now. You got fear demons in there. Let's get them out. Come on out, devil. Satan, loose your hold of the woman of God. Spirit of fear from childhood, come out. Come out of her throat. Come out of that body right now. Quickly. Hurry up. Come out of there. Did you repent of that?
I repented. I said I studied the medical list today.
Come on. No, you did? Okay. Oh, no. Come on now. In the name of Jesus, hold that. Come on. Let your tears go. Come on. Let your tears go. Stop holding back. You're supposed to be healed tonight. Let's get healed tonight. Autoimmune diseases can be wiped out by the Spirit of the Lord. I've seen it happen in front of my eyes. Don't tell me it can't. I've seen it happen. But the person has to repent first. You don't need to be healed of autoimmune disease. You need to repent of having bad feelings about yourself, about a relative, about an abuser. It's usually verbal abuse. Verbal abuse. It's usually regrets. It's usually regrets. Just repent of it right now. Come on, sweetheart. Did you forgive your brother yet? You did for him. Okay, now pray for him. So thus saith the Lord, bless those who curse you. Pray for those who despitefully use you. Love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who despitefully use you. Come on, pray for your brother. Lord God, I want you to hunt her brother down tonight. I want you to go get him. I want you to forgive him for what he done to his sister. I want you to forgive him. Have mercy on him, Lord. Don't let him die and go to hell. Hunt him down, Lord Jesus. Go get him, Lord. We forgive him tonight. She and I, all three of us right here, forgive her brother. We're going to forgive him. We're going to agree in prayer. Where two or three are gathered in the name of the Lord, there is the Holy Ghost right in the midst. We are going to agree, all three of us, that her brother gets forgiven. We're going to pray that she gets forgiven for criticizing herself and seeing herself as ugly and unattractive. She's going to get forgiven for carrying around regrets for decades, triggering an autoimmune disease. Tonight, it's over. Tonight, I repent in the name of Jesus. I no longer dislike myself. I no longer dislike my body. I no longer see me as ugly. I no longer listen to demons run me down physically and mentally. I do not receive that anymore. In Jesus' holy name, I'm not taking it anymore. No more. No more. I'm not living like this anymore. If you are what I call a recycler, you better do some hardcore weeping repentance. Weeping repentance is the only way for recyclers to get delivered. If you're still screwed up now and you were screwed up 2 years ago, you got serious, serious spiritual problems. And you got to grab a hold of the horns of the altar of God and cry your way into a miracle. That's the only way it's going to work. Casual praying is not going to work. Quoting the Bible is not going to work. It's not going to work. You got to cry your way in. You've wasted your life. You've hurt yourself. You've hurt untold numbers of people. You got to cry your way in. Thus saith the Lord. Come on, pray like King David now. Have mercy upon me, Lord, according to thy loving kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. For against thee and thee only have I sinned and done this evil in your sight. YouTubers, this is Brother Mike signing off. Please go to the website, hardcorechristianity.com. Check out the teaching button. Read the article on how Satan controls the mind. Read the article on Satan's counterattack. You will be hit within 48 hours of this service. They're going to try to steal everything you learn tonight and get you reinfected with every demon that came out tonight. Please remember our three Zoom services, Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Please remember our two live services every week, Thursday and Friday nights at 7 o'clock. Please remember, you've been called by God. See you next time.